Go ahead, ma'am. In the other room, go ahead.
Good evening. My name is Melissa Martz. I am an attorney, a child advocate, and I am a mom for liberty. My message tonight, it remains for the powerful law-abiding parents and not the law-breaking criminals sitting at the dais. Parents, this elected school board has more than failed us and our children. They have failed us in academia by choosing to teach topics outside of their given authority, topics like CRT and equity, while at the same time neglecting the thesis of what they are hired to do, to teach reading, writing, and math. Current stats for Palm Beach County School Board show a high school graduation rate of 74.9%. Test scores showed proficiency in math at the elementary, middle school, and high school levels ranging from 47 to 63%, and reading 49 to 55%. Yet, this school board took in $2,354,794,000 of our taxpayer money. If any of us failed at our jobs in this way, we would be fired. This board has been offered money by the federal government through the SAFE program under the U.S. Department of Education. And that is why they don't care that our governor withholds their salaries for their illegal and abusive mask mandate. Our federal government is breaking the law with them. Parents, there is a U.S. bill right now to abolish the unconstitutional U.S. Department of Education. Call your U.S. congressional representatives and demand that they support it.
Oh, there's a bill to abolish the Department of U.S. Department of Education.
Their child is safer testing away from unmasked children. These students also deserve to be accommodated per the ADA statute. One size does not fit all. I am also concerned about this board's knowledge concerning child sex trafficking. I have been an anti-child sex trafficking advocate for the last several years. Victims should not be masked because it impedes identification, and masking a child that suffers with PTSD from child sexual exploitation is insane. And I should know because this is one of the reasons that I myself am not able to wear a mask. Lastly, this board says they care about minorities, yet they are currently being sued for Baker Acting and handcuffing numerous children as young as 5 years old without parental consent. Shockingly, these children are disproportionately Black and disabled. Maybe Ms. Postal would like to help with this. The plan of this board is clearly to vaccinate our children at school. If they will Baker Act your child without your consent, what makes you think they won't vaccinate them without your consent? Parents, you hold the power. There is support in our community and in our legislation to remove your children from these schools, to place them in private schools, co-ops, or homeschooling. The time is now. We the people, free the people.